Hello guys, welcome to another Tool JZ Tuesday. My name is Michael Chung and today I'm going to share with you guys this drive by wire module modified to the Tool JZ engine. Start by telling you guys some of the basics of this drive-by-wire throttle body first. Alright, the first one is Nissan Serena and Primera drive-by-wire throttle body. It is driven by the motor. Alright, and then this one is with six wires. Okay, normally drive-by-wire throttle body has six wires because they got a cool controller wired to the ECU directly, one positive 5 volt, one sensor ground, and two throttle position sensor. Okay, I'm not very sure which one is which for now, but I'm going to show you guys some diagrams later. Alright, the why there are two TPS positions is because one TPS position is to show from 0 to how many volts. Okay, so in this range, for example, this is the throttle position. It is at 0, so when it moves to let's say 2 volts out of 5 volts, okay, so this is what it measures the first TPS. Then the second TPS will measure the second one. The ECU will need the second value to double check and see whether the total amount of these 2 voltage is 5 volts or something like this. This one is to make sure that your drive-by-wire module is not stuck. So when it is stuck, so the ECU will drive in a limp mode. Alright, so this is why our pedal position sensor also comes with six wires also, because they have two TPS too. Alright, okay, so these two is we can see that it's sealed together with a shielded wire. So this one is definitely is the positive and negative direct from the ECU to control the drive-by-wire motor inside, the stepper motor inside. In the first place, why we shield the wire is because we don't want other wires to interfere the signal for these two wires. Alright, we don't want interference of other wires. So we shield it with some sort of metal so that the electromagnetic waves, the electromagnet generated by other wires will not be interfering this signal. But there is also another cheap and easy way to do that I'm going to show you guys, which is you can twist the wires together. Okay, although this one can be a bit crude, but this one is an easy way for me to do. I just twist the wires together. Alright, so these two wires I'll be soldering later, these two direct to the ECU. Alright, one more thing I want to show you guys is since I'm using this Nissan throttle body, so it is not a direct fitment to the 2JZ intake manifold. So what I do is I ask my good friend who is a master in modifying things. Okay, so what he did was very clever. He managed to draw throttle body by using a cardboard and then cut it out and then measure here, and then just nice that all four holes can be drilled here and tapped here. Alright, so that means I don't need a throttle body plate to sandwich in between the throttle body and the intake manifold. Alright, because that one got its problem also and it's quite expensive also. So the idea was I just drill four holes, new holes, and drill here. And also, my good friend Desmond, he also helped me to slightly potter the sharp edges so that to match the round shape of this throttle body. Alright, just to match here so that the airflow more smoothly, you can say that. Alright, okay, of course, if you are using the 2JZ intake manifold, the hole is much bigger than the Nissan one. So somebody may say that, okay, if you're using this small throttle body, it may restrict the air coming in. Yes, right. But for now, this is my limited resources. So in the future, if any company out there will want to support me, because I'm able to draw drawings for throttle body, and I can make a big one, so that I just find popular engines in technical and get their dimensions and just make the adapter plate. That is very easy, and that can sell to a lot of people, because I believe there is a very big market demand for it too. Because drive by wire is a new thing, and it can eliminate idle bar. So when you are using, especially when you are using standalone ECU, when you are turning on your lights, your aircon, you want the ECU, you want the engine to rev higher, so that to compensate the alternator loss of RPM due to the alternator charging back to the battery and providing the electricity to all those electrical appliances. Alright. But some people might say that, okay, 6-cylinder, the RPM drop is very insignificant. But for 4-cylinders, it is quite significant. So you need to rev up a bit. You need some sort of idle air control. But if you are using drive-by-wire, it's all by itself. You can just tell the throttle body to just on slightly more. The primary reason is for me to introduce anti-lag into it. Okay, so what does anti-lag do? Anti-lag is especially 400 horsepower and above, so we might need to use quite a big turbo. With big power comes with big responsibility, so that big responsibility is the turbo lag. Alright, okay, so what does turbo lag means? Okay, turbo lag is the time that the turbo will need to spool at its max efficiency. The turbo lag, the more turbo lag it has, the more time it needs for the exhaust gas to spool up the turbine, to bring up the turbine to up to speed, so that you can get more boost. So especially when you can feel it at very low RPM. Like that. Okay, so this is the turbo lag, the starting part. So turbo lag is something that we don't desire, alright? Okay, unless you are going for drag, maybe you start with 4000 RPM and just rev up to 7000, then when you change gear, it drop to maybe 5000 plus, then go to 7000. So this one, you don't really care about the turbo lag. But especially for drift, for circuit racing, so that is what we want. When we let go, we want the car to slow down a little bit. When we throw, we want instant response, but it doesn't give us because of the turbo lag. So let me come back to the topic of this throttle body, why we use this drive-by-wire throttle body. Okay, so this drive-by-wire throttle body, we can program the ECU so that when we let go the throttle body, it can continue to maintain open, so it will allow air to go in. When the air comes in, but we have the timing. Okay guys, sorry for the interruption. Just now there was a customer came over. So I'm going to show you guys a little bit more. The turbo is having lag issues. It requires more exhaust gas to push the turbine to turn, and then in order to give more boost. Okay, so when you off your throttle, basically you are not receiving much air coming in. So with not much air, not much fuel, so you got less exhaust gas go to your turbo. So this is where anti-lag comes into play. So anti-lag allow, it is a combination of a system that it allows the throttle body to remain open. Alright, so when it open, but you can configure it to be open as 70% or whatever you want. And it allows the ignition to retard. Okay, normally the ignition timing can be 20 to 40 degrees, before top dead center. That means before the piston reaches the top, the spark plug will ignite the fuel mixture. But in the anti-lag system, they purposely ignite the mixture during the top dead center or after the top dead center. It usually retards the timing it's supposed to fire, but it purposely retards so that the mixture will continue to burn even after the exhaust valves are opening. So when the exhaust valves are opening, the fuel mixture is continue to burn, and it, you can say that the explosion, the combustion is happening near the exhaust manifold. So you may burn your exhaust valves, you may burn your exhaust manifold, or the worst case is the turbo itself. Okay, so this one anti-lag system, you, so this one is a disclaimer also, so guys just do at your own discretion, okay? Just have to be very careful. You just slowly, progressively play it, but you have to be very careful with your exhaust gas temperature and stuff like that, okay? But if you cannot, very easy. Just use your eyes to see the exhaust manifold, see whether they are still red, okay? If it is still red, you just have to tone down a bit. Alright, okay, so this is how we use this drive-by-wire throttle body to do the anti-lag system for your engine, okay, especially for our drift. I'm going to continue to learn new things. I hope you guys enjoy learning things together with me, and I hope I can share some of my mistakes and some of my experience in terms of engine building with you guys, and hope you guys enjoy. Please feel free to leave a comment below if you guys got any question about drive-by-wire throttle body, drive-by-wire system. Okay, so that if I got any info, I'll immediately answer you. And don't forget to subscribe if you guys want more info in terms of engine building too. And you guys will be notified immediately when I upload a new video. So I hope you guys stay tuned, and I see you guys.